segment, and we're looking at the summoning of the Senate President, Bukola Saraki, and of course his deputy, Ewerimadu, to the court on June 27. This has created a lot of controversy in the Nigerian polity. Myself and Wolfi, we're still here, and just join us. Dr. Dayo is still also with us. Initially, we intended to look at the pension issue by the Senate, life pension and all that, but because of the exigency of the summoning, we needed to take a different position. Okay, just join us. Is a civil rights activist and a public affairs analyst, Mr. Folabi Bejumo. You're welcome, sir.
My name is a pleasure.
Good morning. And of course, you're one of the spokesperson within the National Conscience Party. Thanks for joining us. Thanks you for coming at just short notice. This is Dr. Dayo Kayode. Okay, all right, so we're fine.
Now, we're talking about the summons of the Senate President, Dr. Bukola Saraki, and Senator Ekweremadu. There's been so much of controversies trailing Senator Bukola Saraki's appointments as the Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And of course, up until date, we've not made any headway with the CCT case. And now we're coming up with a brand new allegation, which of course is also a controversy on the Senate. What is your take on both cases?
Well, number one, it's not a brand
back
new...
Back to back.
It's not the latest one, it's not a brand new one about Senate rules and regulation forgery. This is still an allegation.
Sorry, let me put it in the right context. When I say a brand new case, I mean we're not done with the CCT issue on Saraki, and we're coming up with another, a fresh charge on him again.
And
that's
see,
what I mean.
You see, to those who handle criminal proceedings, they know that even if you have 10 allegations, you face your warrant. That is the point of law. If you like, commit,
even if we don't make any headway,
commit 20 offenses.
Even if we don't make any headway.
There are different matters. There are two different separate matters. Saraki is facing issue of when he was governor in 2003 to 2007. When he was governor, the overestimation or underestimation of his declaration. That is the one that have been pending. And the current one you are now talking about also started a year ago, which has to do with the Senate rules and regulation forgery. Okay. So, honestly, if you have, like, I will take the part of my late boss, Chief Ganifawe, when we agitated, when we saw the tendency of the police there under Obasanjo 1999 to 2003, and the police have power over all these things, but they were not functioning. Okay. We had to agitate for creation of independent, another set of body, which necessitated the creation of ICPC and later EFCC to handle all these criminal cases. Now, as at that time, quite a number of people were questioned, were arrested, except those who are in the rulership, in the headship of the nation, you understand? Governors, ministers, and former whatever, here and there, they were questioned. So my late boss, Chief Ganifa, in your best memory, said, you can only be witch hunted. The language witch hunting came into the vocabulary there. You can only be witch hunted if you have skirmishes, if you have skeletons in your cupboard. Now, if you have two, you cannot be hiding under witch hunting. Now, why some of us support the argument that, okay, go and face your warrant. If you are guilty, you will be pronounced guilty by the law court of a competent jurisdiction. If you are not guilty, you'll be pronounced as such. So, invariably, the latest one, which is the issue of Senator Fudge. You understand? That one is also going on. You can see, I don't know where our senators are coming from, and even the reps, House of Reps. They are making moves, not even sinister again. Open move to initiate what they call immunity, which what some of us call impunity. Mm-hmm. For the Senate President, for the House of Reps Speaker, and what have you. These are people that we are yet to see concretely what positive actions and what positive impact they made on our lives.
Let me interrupt you, please.
In terms of even legislation, what legislations they have done that have impacted positively on the lives of the masses of Nigeria.
A lot of people would disagree with that, and okay. I beg to disagree. Let me ask this question. Sorry, just a moment, Mr. Benjamin. If you're looking at the entire process, for the way Nigeria is structured, yes, we're a developing nation, and we're trying to put the right things in the right places. But this particular administration supposedly has 4 years. If you spend 4 years chasing different corruption cases, and in 1 year we couldn't make any headway out of the CCT trial, what do you foresee in the other proposed cases?
You see, I will go back.
Governance is not all about fighting corruption.
The essence of that, I am not holding brief for Buhari. Buhari has his own laxity too. You understand? Which we are still going to talk about if there's time for that. You understand? And now, if you are talking of crime, you understand? Are you saying criminal law is not part of our governance or is not part of our statutory provisions? Now, it's only that the government is not competent enough to handle all segments. As we are handling criminal matter, as we are handling prosecution of fraudsters in government, of vagabonds in power, VIPs, you must also be going on properly with proper economic plans, economic policy, and in fact, responsible and reliable economic think tank of integrity. You understand? You should not stop that. You understand? So we have right to complain to Mr. President on that, because up to now, he has not gotten even sufficient and, I mean, charismatic and knowledgeable economic team. What he quickly did recently was to quickly convoke what they call the National Economic Council under the Vice President. You understand? And that National Economic Council, as institutionally established, consists of governors. Governors who cannot even govern their own state, many of whom cannot even pay salaries, and until when they go for Filibotting federalism, go to Abuja to go and beg for bailout. So you see, invariably, we need, because our fundamental problem is corruption. Go to every sector of our nation, you see embodiment of corruption. The whole place is thinking with corruption. So if you don't fight corruption, you are deceiving yourself. Go and package all policies, all theories, all practices, from socialism to capitalism, from Jesus Christ to Prophet Muhammad, and even to Ogun and Ifa. So far you have corrupt kleptocrats in governance, rather than democrats, rather than people of integrity. You are bound to fail. So you see, anti-corruption drive is important, but is the government so sincere about the anti-corruption drive?
Okay.
Is it a genuine one? Is it a wish hunting one? It's another topic.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Benjamin. Dr. Dayo, looking at the trial of the so-called expected trial of Saraki and Remadu, would we say that the circumstances with which Saraki came into power has become his nightmare? Is that the major problem? Can't the APC itself, you understand, because Saraki gave his all for that election. He delivered his state, he spent so much money. What is Saraki's sin?
You see, the issue is this. Politics. It's all about using your number six, your common sense. When they wanted to elect people into the leadership of National Assembly, now, okay, including House of Reps, it happened to Gara too. The party APC, they have their own, the way they do to elect their principal officers.
The power sharing formula.
Yes, they have their formula to share all those power. Yeah. But some people are now saying, look, we're supposed to have gone beyond this. Let members of National Assembly elect their leaders. Where they made a mistake was when they had their so-called straw election. And it came up with some people. Now the girl looked at it. I want to become Speaker of the House. This one now look at it. I want to become Senate President. But then looking at the composition of both houses, you see that anybody that is coming from APC, then who can garner the whole support of PDP will definitely win. Saraki now saw that. He based on his being a former member of PDP. Okay. Went with David Mack, with Ekere Madu, and then a little from APC, and he became the Senate President. Why should that be an issue? This same APC, when they were ACN or AC, did the same thing for PDP. Instead of Muli Katz from Oyo State, who was supposed to be the speaker, they came up with, what was his name, who is now a governor in the north, as the speaker.
Tambuwa.
They came up with Tambuwa. Do you understand? And meanwhile, Tambuwa then was a member of PDP. And PDP didn't do anything. But now, for Saraki to have won the Senate presidency, I don't think it should be an issue entirely. This is an issue that we're supposed to have thrown behind us so that we can move forward. You can see that all these things, they are all disturbing the progress of Nigeria.
Gbajumo, some people said it's an inter-party issue. And for the sake of Nigerians, they needed to sort out these things themselves because he's a ruling party. And what do you think about summoning the AGF?
You see, first and foremost, I want to explain briefly the issue of the APC crisis.
The Saraki
and whatever, to me, is not an inter-party anything. You know why? The PDP, this set of people who are in power today, were criticizing, were part and parcel of the founders of what is now known as APC. So to many of us, and to those who can critically, constructively assess and analyze situation, you know that PDP is APC, APC is PDP.
Yes, you understand that, but the politicians understand that.
We must understand that. You see, now the issue of crisis within the APC, in terms of leadership or Senate presidency, as of speaker, whatever, to me, it is the goals of the poor masses whose life have been wrecked by these questionable characters that is playing back. Go and check the foundation of the APC. When they were starting it off, we said a rainbow coalition cannot work. It's a bird of the same feather. And you must expect that, not in the interest of the people, you must expect the coalition among the coalition, from their coalition to coalition. You understand? You must expect that because Saraki wants to become president, Senate president, not because he has your interest or my interest. Dogara wanted to become your speaker, not because of your interest or my interest. And quite a number of them, they are running for immunity now because many of them know that they have tainted their hands. Mm-hmm. If we have genuine and sincere anti-corruption drive, some of them are supposed to be in jail. So you see, we should not be overburdening ourselves on the issue of wish hunting. Do those who are prosecuting them or who are investigating them, do they have evidence? And in law, when you have evidence, you should be prosecuted. You understand? So we don't let us join them. It's why I need more of that crisis. Because the more of that crisis, the more we'll be able to find solution to the problem of Nigeria. I'm coming. Because the unity of fraudsters in government is against the progress masses of the common masses of this
nation. There is no progress in division. Let us be as objective as possible.
There's no what?
There's no progress in division.
What do you mean by that?
Division.
My sister, no, please. When you are talking of those who are committing crime, who have institutions that are handling corruption, criminality, have evidence against them. You are saying that they should be united. United for what? When they were united, they gave us progress?
I'm not saying they should be
they did
united.
Not give us progress. I don't want their unity. Unity is going to create more repercussions.
You see, it's not about unity now.
Nobody wants to see more of this chaos, more of this disunity. So,
among them.
And I'm saying a house divided against itself cannot stand. Of what use is it to us Nigerians?
House based on fraud. House based on impunity. You are looking for immunity for them to further commit further crime, further fraud against the
government.
Talk of unity when you have genuine set of people who are giving us progression. Only pray for their unity. You see, the more they are unified, you know, that's why when they come again.
I'm coming.
You will talk. I'm a guest. You understand? You are the one to moderate.
Yes.
But can you allow me?
No, I'm coming. You will talk. You will talk. You have your day. Okay. But I don't want to lose
Your thoughts. Okay, go ahead.
So you see, basically, when you are united in truth, fairness to the people, mm-hmm. and genuine progress of the people,
sure.
good. But in a situation where you say, okay, as you come to mosque, as you come
it is you that is getting it. You know that they are not even united. Let me tell you this. They are united. They are united. It is true. They are not united. They are united. They know what they are doing.
Okay.
You see, they are creating such problems to divert our attention. Let me tell you this. I have seen 2-3 friends today. They don't see eyeball to eyeball again. Because of supposed infractions between these people. Look at this. I may mention something some times ago that Bukola Saraki is being investigated by CCT. Forget about that. They know what they are doing. We should not be happy about it at all. Say, yes, God has caught him, this and that. No. It is because they are putting him on his toes so that he himself will not be able to act on their own infractions. I don't know whether you understand. Look at this. Recently, it was docked at CCTV. I mean, as a CCT. Before you know it, the guy just came. He said, okay, we are adjourning for 3 weeks or so. Because they cannot see this, they cannot see that.
Senate president
are
talking about.
Do you understand? So if they are serious, why are they missing this and that? If they are serious, if they are not in unity, why have they not been able with all the retinue of evidences against him?
Excuse me,
they know what they are doing. They are in unity.
Wait, there is a legal process that is still ongoing.
Forget about that legal process. The legal process they have been following now. What else against?
I want to define the area of you saying no armed robbers. Go and check it very well. We want to be disunited, especially when they are sharing the loot. But when they are sharing the loot, they become disunited. Because of greed of someone.
You have even argued against yourself now. You have argued against yourself now. Look at hand robbers. Look at hand robbers. We are policemen.
I'm talking of hand robbers as an instance. Okay. This is as a parable. Nobody has judged any one of them as hand robber now. But I'm giving an example.
Okay.
If hand robbers, the only, much of occasion where they are being captured, sometimes, go and check police record. When they are being captured, sometimes it's when they were escaped, they were about to kill themselves about sharing. This is the same thing that is occurring for us, which is now giving us a lot of spotlight. You understand? Now I'm coming. Because when they were sharing, go and check the record of their salaries. Okay. It has not changed. The record of the money they are collecting, it has not changed. None of them fight on that. But position, that position is very, very important because they hand more. You understand? Now, if you now allow them to be so united, you understand, in fraud, you understand, in criminality, allegedly, we are creating a lot of problems. We need more of that. So that when you expose them, we want to see the performance of EFCC.
She wants to ask you a question.
Okay. I mean, if I want to talk personally from my own point of view, I'll be talking about a lot of personal sentiments. But we should keep personal sentiments aside and face the issue just the way
what
it is.
What is personal sentiment?
No, the question I want to ask is, initially, the Saraki came in through the back door. Let me use the words Nigerians used.
Yeah.
But you know, if you have 2/3 of the Senate, you can actually elect a Senate president. And there was more than 2/3 sitting in the Senate on that particular day. Yeah. But that's not the question I'm asking about today. Now, the Senate president's been dropped. Ekweremadu Madu under this controversy. What does it portend to the international community? Is it a good thing that we Nigerians are calming down and fighting people who are the best because we want to give the impression to the world that we are incorruptible people.
Okay, Mr. Gbejumo, your reply to the question.
My sister, you are just still going back. The best, most renowned international expression and critical analysis in summation of what Nigeria is to the international world was done by David Cameron of United Kingdom.
Okay.
Fantastically corrupt. There's no understatement or overstatement about that.
We keep fighting ourselves and putting ourselves in the eye of these people. Is this the right thing to do?
They know, for your information, those people know your country more than yourself.
Sure.
UK, USA, the superpowers, they Canada. Want this country. No, I'm coming. I'm coming. Wait,
he
wait,
needs,
wait.
He needs almost wait, everybody, almost wait. All the leaders cannot
you
be
see,
you
see,
wait, no, I'm coming. I'm coming. I'll answer.
You hold see, on, yeah.
Don't they let us.
Know, you know, you see, they know this country more than they say. You understand? For you to have better image abroad in the Committee of Nations. That's why some of us criticize the drunken thing abroad of Mr. President himself. Because it is your home. If your home is well done, if you have proper progression, developmental agenda, if your electricity is very regular, as we are within your studio now, you are running on generator, you are running on diesel. If you have proper internal solution to your problem, the foreigners will rush in. FDI will come in troves, foreign investments. You understand? So you see, you don't need to be saying that you are throwing our image abroad. They know much of your image. Look at your three House of Reps member who have been alleged of committing rape. You understand? In the United States of America, and they carry the diplomatic passport of Nigeria.
Okay, Mr. Bajumo.
Some of them are
Mr. Bajumo. Let's try to water down this discussion to the topic.
Yeah, basically. To the topic. Yes.
I just want to ask you a straight question. Saraki is still battling with the CCT, and now we are being told for forgery. If you look at it critically, do you suspect this is the mindset of certain political analysts that there seems to be a strategy to make sure that the executive have a strong grip or manipulating grip of the legislature. Do you agree with that suspicion?
You see, I don't want to fully agree on that for one reason. If we have had pro-masses legislation for the past 17 years, many of the amendments many of us have been agitating for will have been done. Whether you like it or not, under the military constitution, we are still running 1999 military decree as a constitution. The constitution that lied against itself, we the people of Nigeria, where you and me, I were not given opportunity. How far have the Senate and House of Reps gone in amending the overbearing power of the executive?
Yeah.
How far have they gone? They have not done anything. You understand? So far, their own huge salaries, allowances, wardrobe allowance, newspaper allowance, furniture allowances are not tampered.
They are concerned with their self-interest.
So basically, the executive, I mean, if you want to say it directly, the presidency have overbearing power because the constitution gave him the overbearing power. Because we are not running even what the constitution specifies as Federal Republic of Nigeria. What we are running is a unitary system of government. And that's why you see many of them even fighting themselves to be senator, to be rep, to be minister, and whatever, and to be president. You understand? Because of what they are going to acquire over there. So basically, if you are saying the president is having overbearing, the constitution...
No, I'm not saying these are political analysts.
No, the constitution provides for it. You understand? But how far the senators, the Senate, and the House of Reps also have power. You can amend some other thing. Okay, why does the so-called amendment to the alteration to the constitution have been failing? Since 2009, I was almost crucified at the Senate hearing, Western Zone here in Lagos, when I faced the then chairman of that committee, Senator Folari is no more a senator now, and Mamura. I told them, you people are not interested in genuine amendment of constitution or alteration of the constitution. You are only interested in the 1 billion naira that was adjusted.
Okay, let me help you out on.
The executive will keep all of that power in the constitution.
Your point is made.
Let me help you out on that. You see, we have to look at this thing in totality. When you are looking at the executive being overbearing on the legislature, you have to look at what level of control is the executive having on the judiciary? Who comes around to interpret that constitution?
There's another angle.
Do you understand? You have to look at it from that angle, because these people, they know where they are heading to. Let me tell you this. When you are saying constitution give the executive the power to this, to that. The question is this: he who pays the piper dictates the tune. We have seen a lot of judicial instructions in this country. That it's not that the judge or whatever doesn't know what is right, but because the voices of the executive needs to be heard, and based on that they will give their judgment. And another one, we now when they decide to go against the whatever, another judge will come who is fearless, who doesn't want to listen to the executive, and then we give a counter judgment. A case in view is that of Wike, the same day. Different judgments were given in Port Harcourt and was it Abuja or Lagos? Either Abuja or Lagos. Do you understand? So to that extent, I have said it, our constitution, one, is faulty.
Okay, thank you.
We need to amend our constitution or come up with people's constitution.
Now, Mr. Bajimo,
by the people. By this set of leaders.
Let's look at the leadership style of our president right away. A lot of people have started using the word authoritarian. Dictator.
Totalitarian.
Fascist. And these were the same words when the president was the head of state in the khaki uniform. Now, so far, would you say some of the actions of the president, in as much as we know he has good intentions, are impeachable offenses?
It is left for the National Assembly to examine that, impeachable offenses or not. Yes, definitely, there are certain areas where Mr. President has faulted. I have told you severally. Number one, I condemn, is when you people said you are coming on change mantra, that everything, many things will change in the area of expenditure, in the area of these unnecessary wastages all over the place, while the masses of Nigeria are suffering. But you later came in. What we have also been seeing, you understand, is unnecessary expenses. Go to the presidency, the same way we had in the past, where you have, okay, today you have two prominent special assistants to the president on media and publicity. On what? Femi Adesina on one side, Garuba on one side. And again, you see our minister for information. These are excesses. These are unnecessary expenses. You understand? Now, if people now come up and say, Mr. President is trying to be draconian, or he's trying to be authoritarian, or still has not dropped his military mentality. Yes, to a certain extent, there are some point, because you have seen it. Even the promises you people you made, you have now turned it to all promises cancelled. That's what the
for APC.
Is that why the executive is afraid that if there's some kind of calmness in the Senate, they might likely begin to think about troubling the execution.
Excuse me, don't forget, this same scenario occurred under Obasanjo. If you are in a National Assembly that is not functional, in the recess of performance for diplomacies, you are bent to also create certain things. The presidency itself, the executive itself, when they are not functional, they are also bent, because the real people that can determine the impeachment of the executive or the president at the National Assembly. You understand? So being that as it were, they will concord whatever. Possibly to rake in money, but maybe the president himself is trying to be too much of Mr. Blue, whereas he's also overspending to his own side against the side of the National Assembly. So you should expect all these things, because we are yet to have sincere and truly true leader that have true integrity, that have true heart of solving the problem of the masses. There are many of them are just for their own pocket, you know. You understand? They are not concerned about what is going on or what is the suffering of the masses. Go and check even their policy. The policy of increment to petroleum flow. Who buys petrol? Who buys fuel? It is me and you. Who pay? They don't pay.
But when you talk about all of this,
go to even the center where they collect fuel. They don't buy fuel.
Some people would say it's easier to talk from the back. You know, it's easier to talk when you're on the ground side than when you're on the podium. So many other parties will come up during presidential elections and come up with very beautiful blueprints. And when they get in there, they get to see the realities. And most times they don't perform.
That is where your job. That is why your job here is commendable. That is why we must not stop to talk. Because we are not prophets that can see if Mr. Ben, as our presidential candidate, is deceiving us until when he gets there. So they can only make promises by law.
So you can look at antecedents. You can look at antecedents.
Sometimes you look at antecedents. Okay, people, quite a lot of us look at the antecedent of Buhari.
Yeah.
And that's why that if, because the ruling class had the problem. You understand? Don't think they have major problem. They have seen that we also, because gone are the days over 30 years ago when it was military justice, when the level of education of people were not so spectacular as it is today, when people cannot deeply criticize, except few of us as are there. You understand? Now, people have been seeing and they have been criticizing them. And we must continue that because people will deceive you. They will.
But do you know that most of the points being raised based on his antecedents are now happening?
No, excuse me.
Most of the points being raised then against him.
Based on his antecedents.
Yes, based on his antecedents are now happening.
Yes, exactly. So sometimes somebody may have maybe something you feel is a positive antecedent. But because of the power that is in his hand now,
a journalist was just sent out yesterday.
So you know, my brother, the point is that we must not stop this kind of commendable program.
But what if
criticize them constructively?
What if
brings a different set of people for them to know that we know what's going on? But I keep on saying we need more of staccato of confusion among them, so that we know more of fraud, we know more of what they are committing. Pending the time, we, the masses of Nigeria, we go and march on there. They are telling for that to march on there.
Excuse me, what if at the end of the day, the forgery trial of Saraki and Ekweremadu, Saraki and Ekweremadu goes down, what do you think would come up in the Senate?
You see, that question.
What do you think would happen in the legislature?
We'll get your reaction.
And if someone else is chosen, it has to be from the 8th Senate. To replace our Kanikuri Madu, do you think there might be, you know, they say in every saint there's a piece of a devil, and in every devil there's a piece of a saint.
Mm.
If someone now comes up from the Senate to replace Ikuri Madu and Saraki, do you think they'll be much better? Do you think their records too might not have controversies much later?
You see, I have this mentality of we the people of Nigeria, that whether you are black or you are white or red or you are a monster, and you become president of this country, so far my life and your life is being bettered. We are not, we don't care, you understand? But when you are there, no matter how handsome your face is or how beautiful your face is, and he's not putting bread and butter on our tables, and it continues to deplete our own resources and livelihood, we are bound to fight.
That's okay, now, thank you.
Point I'm going to is that the set of people that are there now, go and change them 10 times. They were changed many times under Obasanjo.
They are recycled.
They recycled themselves. Go and change. So far, you still have the system that have not changed. You will still have.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Bajumo. Let's have Dr. Dyer's comment.
My own comment is going to be like a question to you. If you are saying the people occupying those positions now, they are occupying those positions illegally. Are we now saying everything they have done, all the exercises they have partaked in, are also illegal?
No, I think maybe you are putting.
I'm only trying to react.
Okay.
Because if you are saying the way they are there is illegal, then that automatically it's not you.
Yeah.
But for the court. The word from that word forgery, do you understand? Forgery will only lead to illegality. Do you understand?
Forgery is illegal.
Yes, a function of that forgery brought in Saraki, Ekweremadu, and the rest. Do you understand? Then that means automatically they are occupying that position illegally, and if they are occupying that position illegally, then that means everything they have done in the past should be regarded as illegal. Somebody now asked the question. And I said, my friend, I've gotten my first degree. Supposing they now find out that the HOD then has a fake doctorate degree. I said, okay, there's a Yoruba proverb which says, show me your friend. Then I will use it. I mean, show me your friend. Then I will determine the kind of person you are. If you have a fake HOD, then you have to look at those people that are working with that HOD. Then they must be having also fake certificates. So what do you expect from such people?
What are your solutions? What solutions
you see,
are you preferring?
To me, I don't expect much.
We just have one minute.
I don't expect much from them. Each senator and total per month, 29,479,000. Solution is that the masses of we, the people of Nigeria, no matter your religion, your tribe, or ethnicity that they have been using against one another in this country, we must stand for our rights. Chief Gadivari said, we must stand, even if we are standing alone, we must stand and face these people and occupy the National Assembly and even government of this country.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bajumo, for coming on the program. Dr. Dayo, thank you.
My pleasure.
Normally on Wednesdays, we used to take a look at the education sector. But you know, as a media organization, we must be very dynamic and swift to action based on what you know is trendy at this point in time. So next week we would endeavor to take a look at the education sector. Join our colleague tomorrow, Anira and Rumalia, for an interesting package. Thank you, gentlemen. Wolfan,
it's a pleasure. It's a wholesome day. Thank you so much for sharing your time out and your intellectual thoughts with us. Yes, on Ekweremadu and Saraki's case, we'd say let the law take its course and let the best win. My name is Wolfan Isamin. It's been very wonderful talking with you on this broadcast. See you again on